Nick, you can forget that first round win. These coaches have to tell their kids it's one and done in this second round game between the Akron Zips and the Butler Bulldogs.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Bulldogs are facing a very formidable opponent, Dick. What are the keys to their success?
Hey, tonight the keys to their success are these, Brad. Number one, the point guard has to be the floor general. It's up to him to ensure that his team executes and has efficiency on both sides of the floor. Secondly, if you win the glass, baby, and you'll own the boards, you'll win the game. And finally, be aggressive defensively. Don't give them any open looks.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. Adam in the low block, but opted against it. He fakes the shot. He attempts the three.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
Both teams looking to get things going here.
Watch out, 5 second call approaching.
Buried it.
This one deserves another look, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. Wide open for the shot. He shoots from the top of the circle.
Wow, let's check out the replay.
The power forward with the ball. And he'll kick it back outside. Gave it up. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
He knocks down another bucket.
This kid's got skills, Brad.
The small forward gets the ball. Way off target. The point guard gets the pass. Now trying to feed the low block. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Number one is emotionally pumped up.
Hey, Brad, I love players that play with emotion. That's why I love the college game.
He bombs from outside. The dribble, gives it up. Big man spins down the low block.
Does a great job getting the defensive player to lean one way and spin back the other. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Puts it up, looking for contact. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Down inside. They work the perimeter. Turns it over. And a momentary look from three-point land. The point guard takes the pass. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure. Just enough to force the steal. Got to make that baby. Had a wide open angle. Have a chance to lay it on the glass for easy deuce. Try to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. Kicks it out.
Shooter spotting up on a three.
Looking for a screen on top and got it. He fires from long range. Perfectly designed, perfectly executed easy basket. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. Fake. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. K Trying to feed the low block. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
Tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
The shooting guard takes the feed. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. There's a high screen. He launches a three. Off the rim and no good. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. And as you would say right here, Mr. Vitale, Flop City!
I tell you one thing, absolutely a flop. No doubt, Mr. Nessler.
Gave it up. He looks at the hoop. And up. And he missed. The Bulldogs have a number of seniors in their lineup. That factor alone will definitely help their cause. Way off target. I think a defensive stop on this possession, Dick, will have this crowd just roaring. He tries the three ball. He nails the bucket. He keeps his dribble as they reset. They work it around the perimeter. Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
On the dribble, gives it up, fakes it.
What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
Off the rim and no good. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
He went for the steal in the post, and he missed it, Dick.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. What a poor job defensively. He gambled.
The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension.
They go into the low block. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defense.
Gets the rejection. The ball goes out of bounds. You talk about a packed house. Look at this crowd.
I tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge.
Working it around the perimeter. And the ball goes out of bounds. Oh, and look at the crowd and look at the reaction.
I tell you, the home fans are going crazy. There's jubilation.
Baseline, now the kick out. He shoots from right of the circle. There was no doubt about that one. From the top of the circle.
He kept the ball on the floor and waited for his teammate to set that screen for the sweet jumper. Boy, that was beautiful.
Right of the circle, way off target. This young guy is a crowd favorite, Dick.
He's very popular, Brad. He has done some great things on the court, and the people really appreciate him for it.
Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
Jumped in front to take it away. Stolen pass.
Hey, he read his eyes on that one, Brad.
A light steal attempt by the defense.
In addition to the pressure defense, they're going for some aggressive steals as well.
He looks for the bomb. Off the rim and no good. There's the fake. Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offensive transition.
Here he is defensively, and this is going to be an Academy Award, Dick.
Absolutely, Academy Award at its best.
Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see raw man. That's essential when you play on there and you're fronting.
And the ball goes out of play. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
Shot clock is dead. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Too much contact there. It knocked him off balance a little. Looking for a good shot. Unloads a three. Way off target. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. How many bricks have we seen? Will somebody make a jump shot, please?
At the end of the first half, the Zips are ahead by two. Akron has hit a ton of three-pointers in this first half, Dick.
And if you ask me, Brad, I think that was the difference in the first half.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. Number 32, pump fakes with the fake. Jump hook from the low block. There's a very tight lid on that rim for him right now, Dick.
That's right, Brad. Nothing seems to be dropping. The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. The crowd really admires this young man.
The fans know exactly how much he has done for this program.
Now they work it around the perimeter. The ball goes out of play. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches.
He was applying great pressure defense. Went for the steal, but he wound up with a personal foul instead.
That's why some coaches don't like it when players go for the steal. They end up with fouls or in foul trouble.
Gave it up. Good fake. Now the turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, and possibly a block.
He drains the bucket. Now that's what I call showtime.
You better believe it, baby. Look at that spacing.
There's a bad pass right to the defender. In the paint. Butler are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. And in and out. The small forward takes the pass. The ball goes out of bounds. Standing ovation. You've got to love this reaction by the crowd.
What emotion, what passion. The crowd appreciates their effort. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box. There's the trap.
He takes the three. Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Dumps it in. Picks off the lazy pass. Too physical. The Bulldogs will step to the line for the first time. He makes the first shot. And he doesn't miss that opportunity either. They're working around the arc. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Way out on top, controlling the ball.
Great play to take that to the basket.
On the outside.
Nice high post screen.
He goes for the trifecta. He's taking his team out of the game plan with these shots, Dick.
Yeah, and even if you were hitting them, Brad, they're still bad shots.
He attempts the trifecta. Off the rim and no good. There they come with a double team to stop it. From three-point range. Tough offensive, defensive rebound.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Butler are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now.
Goes up for two. In and out. Pushes it up. He intercepts it. Working it around the perimeter. Looking for the foul. And he scores despite the hack. Gave it up. He launches the bomb. No luck finding the basket the last few trips down court, Dick.
What they need are some easy layups or a couple of nice putbacks.
He launches a three. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
A on the dribble, gives it up.
Nice fake.
And he'll kick it back outside. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, a sense of urgency down here on the bench. The coaching staff is starting to sense their players are starting to panic, and they want that stopped before any further damage is done. Guys?
He lets it fly. The Bulldogs have found a player who cannot seem to miss it.
Brad, he's on fire.
From outside. You can't go those kind of stretches against a team of this quality and expect to win. They've got a player spotting up on the three. Takes away the pass. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Fakes the jumper with a jump hook.
I'll tell you, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
There's the pick. And the ball goes out of bounds. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
He shoots from left of the circle. Off the rim and no good. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Can't get the shot to drop. He launches the bomb. Rims out. For two, sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Comes defensively on him on the low block. Dick.
I tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position, spreading his body and getting the ball.
See more focused play on both sides.
One would assume so.
He shoots from outside. Off the rim and no good. Working around the perimeter. Fires away.
If they can get off some good shots and easy buckets, it might turn around this awful stretch of shooting for them, Brad.
Easier said than done, though, right now, Dick. Rims out. The point guard gets the pass.
Up and inside.
Now they work it around the perimeter.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important than how talented guards that they have.
Yeah, that helps. And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
Gave it up. Got the shot if he wants it. Great defense. He puts up the tray. Off the rim and no good. Shot clock is dead. They work the perimeter. The power forward handles the pass.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
They're going to move it around the perimeter. Has a nice look at the basket. Number one with the foul. Well, here's a look at the turnover situation, Dick. Probably one of the stats that coaches really care about the most.
I'll tell you, definitely, Brad. Turnovers are missed shot opportunities. And without shot opportunities, winning games becomes really difficult.
And the ball goes out of play. Dick, I think the better team won. We can say that. And it's heartbreak for the other club, but you know, you've got to win it and keep on going to get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
The Bulldogs graduates to the Sweet 16 now with two big wins in the first round.
Let me tell you, the coach has really lit a fire under the bellies of his players. Their opponents better come to play in the third round because these kids will be ready.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.